My name is Henry Guerra. Here recently, I was laid off on March the 24th, and I've been receiving. I'm going to pantry after pantry after pantry. Yeah.
What were you working in before you were laid off?
I was in hotel management. I've been working almost 40 years. I've never needed assistance, and after I was laid off, when they paid me, you know, my vacation and everything, I paid all of my bills through the end of May, and so I knew I have that, you know, I'm not stressing to pay all those bills yet. I better get on it, and I better do what I need to do, so I applied for food stamps, and when I called 211, they said that I needed to go to this location off of Cameron Road. I went there. I was the second person in line. And when I walked in, they gave me a form and they said, here, fill out this form. Now go stand in the back of the line. And so I was like, oh my word. Then I was like number 89 and I had to go pick up my son from school. So I did not, I didn't fill it out. But I thought that was kind of, when I was talking to them at 211, they should have said, hey, this is the procedure that's gonna occur or you can go online and apply, and they didn't. So. But I'm grateful for all the help I'm getting. I'm not complaining, not at all.
And so what was the difference between doing that and your experience today?
Well, today, Lauren walked me through it, and we filled out the application right then and there, because all I'm applying for right now is just emergency assistance, and because I will be getting unemployment, and I don't want that to be affected. And so, you know, if I can qualify and I'm able to get that, well, I'm that much better off. I just don't want my kids to stress out, and... that's been the hardest thing for me, is making sure that their world remains calm and the same. And so, like I was telling Lauren, you know, I'm doing the laundry in the sink because I can't afford to go to a laundromat, and then I dry it out. And they don't know any of that because that occurs while they're at school. And so when they come home, their clothes are clean. And so everything's fine. Yeah, and I have supper ready waiting for them and help them with their homework. And, you know, I'm a single father and I've been raising my kids for years. And the hardest thing is that they miss their mother tremendously. So I just don't want them to worry, you know, because like today I got my bank statement and I have $8 in my bank. And I was like, oh, Lord, you know, as long as we have food, I think I'm going to be okay, you know.
I think that's all the questions I have. Is there any final
No,
things?
Elise, thank you so much. And, you know, I wish you guys all the best. And thank y'all for being so patient. Just being here really matters. I really appreciate y'all.